Hi, welcome to Big Data Analytics tutorial. In this video, I will solve a numerical example to understand a priori algorithm. Here, we have been given 9 transactions. In each transaction, a customer will buy a certain set of products. The products are marked with I1, I2, I3, I4 and I5. These are the 5 products, and out of these particular 5 products, in each transaction, customer will buy a certain set of products here. The objective of this example is to find the set of rules where the minimum support is 2 and the confidence is 50%. So that is what actually the main objective of this particular problem. Now, how to calculate the support? That's the very first question in front of us. If you want to calculate the support, let us assume that x to y, this is the rule. The minimum support, or can say the support, is always equivalent to frequency of xy divided by n. That is the number of times the items X and Y were bought together divided by the total number of transactions. Similarly, the confidence is equivalent to frequency of XY, that is the total number of times the items X and Y were bought together divided by the total number of times the item X was bought in the total transactions. So this is how actually we can calculate the confidence. So in this case, the support minimum support is equivalent to 2, so there is no need to calculate this value. So only thing is the value of support, or the number of times that items should be bought 2 times. So that is what the simple thing here. And the minimum confidence should be set is 60%. So we should have or we should select the rule where the minimum confidence is minimum 60%. So that is what the thing, 60% or 50%. So 50% in this case. Now, we will start the solving the problem. So this is the transactions given to us. There are 9 transactions and a certain number of products were bought in each and every transaction. So first, what we do in a priori algorithm is we will calculate the frequent item sets. Once you get the frequent item sets, from frequent item sets, we'll try to form the rules. So initially, we will start with one item at a time. So that's the reason this table is named as one item sets and the frequency. So there are 5 items are there, that is I1, I2, I3, I4 and I5. In the frequency column, we need to count the number of times item 1 was bought, and then we need to write here. So if you count here, this item 1, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So it was bought 6 times. Similarly, I2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. The item 2 was bought 7 times. So similarly, we need to identify, or we need to count the number of times I3, I4 and I5 were bought, and then we need to write here. So as per the problem definition is concerned, we need to find all the item sets where the minimum support is satisfied. What is the minimum support? The minimum support should be 2. So in this case, if you look at all the one item sets, all of them will satisfy that particular requirement, because everywhere we have minimum support is 2 or more only. So the frequent one item sets are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and their frequency is 6, 7, 5, 4 and 2 respectively. Now what we need to do is from these one item sets, or frequent one item sets, we need to write 2 item sets. So how can we write it? 2, 1, I1, I2, I1, I3, I1, I4, I1, I5, that is the first set of groups, and I2, I3, I2, I4, I2, I5 is the next one, I3, I4, I3, I5 is the next one, and the last one is I4, I5. So totally 10, 2 frequent item sets, 2 item sets we get. So I have listed all those 10 possibilities here. And then now what we need to do is we need to count how many number of times item 1 and 2 were bought together. So if you see here, item 1 and 2 is present here, second time it is present here, third time it is present here, and fourth time it is present here. So totally it was bought 4 times. Similarly, I1 and I3. So I1 and I3, it is present here, it is present second time here, this is the third time, and this is the fourth time. So total it is present 4 times. Similarly, we need to identify all the frequencies for all these particular 2 item sets. So once you do this particular thing, again we need to identify the frequent item sets. What is frequent item set? The item set which satisfies the minimum support. So minimum support is what? 2 in this case. So this will satisfy, this will satisfy, this will satisfy, this one will satisfy, this is satisfied, and this L will satisfy it. And I1, I4 will not satisfy, I3, I4, I3, I5 and I4, I5 will not satisfy the minimum support. Hence they are not called as frequent 2 item sets. So we'll write only those item sets which will satisfy the the minimum support. So these are the things, and there as associated frequencies written here. Now what we need to do is, from these two frequent two item sets, we need to write three item sets. So if you look at here, what all items are present? I1 is present, I2 is present, I3, I4, I5, all of them are present. Now what we need to do is, from these item sets, we need to write three item sets. So that can be written here. So how many are there? I1, I2, I3, I4 and I5, all of them are there. So how can we write it? I1, I2, I3, that's the one possibility. I1, I2, I4, I1, I2, I5. And then I1, I3, I4, I1, I3, I5. I1, I4, I5. So these are the possibilities with respect to I1. Next, we need to start with I2 here. Now, I2, I3, I4, I2, I3, I5, I2, I4, I5. These are the possibilities. Next is I3, I4, I5. So that is the thing written here. Now, once you write three item sets, the next question is to write the frequency. So count these particular possibilities. So I1, I2, I3. So I1, I2, I3, it is present here and it is present here. So it is coming, or it has been bought two times. So we need to write two here. Similarly, we need to count all the possibilities and write those particular values over here. Now, once you write this frequency, we need to identify the frequent three item sets. That is the item sets which were bought or which will satisfy the minimum support. So in this case, only two will satisfy. That is I1, I2, I3 and I1, I2, I5. Because the minimum support expected is 2, so that is what is written in this case. So these are two item sets which will satisfy the minimum support. Hence, these are called as frequent 3 item sets. Now, what all things are present here? I1, I2, I3 and I5. That is 4 items are present. So definitely we can form 4 item sets here. So the 4 item sets are that's I1, I2, I3 and I5. Now we need to count how many number of times it is appearing. How many number of times it is appearing? It is appearing only one here. So that is the frequency. Whether it will satisfy the minimum support? No, it will not satisfy the minimum support. Hence, it will not become a frequent 4 item set. So because there is no frequent 4 item set, we need to go back to one level up, and then we need to find whatever the frequent item sets are there are present. They are the actual frequent item sets. So in this case, frequent 3 item set is the final answer here. That is I1, I2, I3, I1, I2, I5 with frequency 2 and 2. So this is how actually we can find the frequent item sets. Once we get the frequent item sets, the next question is to identify the rules which will satisfy the minimum confidence. The minimum confidence is 50% here. Now we have two frequent item sets. One is 1, 2, 3 and second one is 1, 2, 5. The minimum support expected is 2, that is 2 by 9, which is equivalent to 22.22%, and the minimum confidence expected is 50%. Now, how to calculate how to write the rules is, we need to follow some procedure here. The very first thing what we need to do is, we need to write all the non-empty subsets of frequent item set. The non-empty subsets of a frequent item set 1, 2, 3 are subset 1, subset 2, subset 3, subset 1, 2, subset 1, 3 and subset 2, 3. Similarly, for frequent item set 1, 2, 5, subset 1, subset 2, subset 3, subset 1, 2, 1, 5 and then 2, 5. Now, once you write these things, we need to write a rules. How to write a rule? If you want to write a association rule, we need to follow this, can say that the procedure. Here, for every non-empty subset, yes. There are some non-empty subsets are there. For every non-empty subset S of I, S of a particular item set, frequent item set, the association rule is S tends to I minus S. S is nothing but the subset. I is nothing but a frequent item set. So if we consider S is equivalent to the subset containing element 1, that is 1 here. So what is I minus S? I is 1, 2, 3. So remove that I, remaining is 2, 3. So this will be 2, 3. 1 tends to 2, 3. That is what the rule in this case. Now, whether this rule is the valid rule, we need to check it out. That is, we need to check whether the support of I, that is the frequent item set, divided by support of subset is greater than or equivalent to minimum confidence. If this value, that is support of I divided by support of subset, is greater than or equivalent to minimum confidence, definitely it is a valid rule. Otherwise, it is an invalid rule. Now I will show you how to write rules. I will consider the first frequent item set, that is 1, 2, 3. I will write the non-empty subsets. In the previous slide, I have shown you how to write it. Now, what we need to do is we need to write the rules. So, consider that 1 is the subset, the remaining are 2, 3, that will be the I minus S here. So, S will be 1, I minus S will be 2, 3. Now, support is, I think, how many times this 1, 2, 3 is appearing, that is, support of this rule is, it is appearing 2 times divided by total number of transactions. So, if you want to cross check it, you just check it, how many number of times 1, 2, 3 is appearing? 2 times, okay. So, 2 divided by 9, that is equivalent to 22.22%. This will be same for all the rules when it comes to this particular frequent item set. So, only thing is we need to calculate this confidence. So, how to calculate the confidence? The confidence is equivalent to support of 1, 2, 3, that is the support of I, divided by support of 1, that is nothing but support of S here. So, S is what? 1 in this case. So, support of 1, 2, 3 divided by support of 1. So, support of 1, 2, 3 is equivalent to what? 2 divided by 9, because it is appearing 2 times out of 9 transactions. What is support of 1? We just go back and see what is the support of 1. If you look at here, the support of 1 is, it is appearing 6 times out of 9 transactions. So, it will be 6 in this case. So, 6 divided by 9. 9 will get cancelled here. 2 by 6, that will be equivalent to 33.34%, which is less than 50% of minimum confidence. Hence, this rule is an invalid rule. Similarly, if you consider subset as 2, the remaining elements are 1 and 3. So, that is I minus S. Support will be 22.22 as it is. Now, we need to calculate the confidence. So, how to calculate the confidence? Confidence is equivalent to support of 1, 2, 3 divided by support of 2. Now, we need to go back and check it out how many times 2 is appearing. It is appearing 7 times. So, it will be 2 by 7, which is equivalent to 28.57. Again, it is less than the minimum confidence, that is 50%. Hence, it is an invalid rule. Coming back to the third rule, we will consider this subset, that is 3. If you consider 3, it is 1, 2. It is a slight mistake here. It is actually 1, 2 here. I just correct it. Now, 3 is S and the subset I minus S is 1, 2. Support is 22.22% as it is. Now, confidence is equivalent to support of 1, 2, 3 divided by support of 3. Support of 1, 2, 3 is 2 by 9. Support of 3 is equivalent to, we just check it out, that is equivalent to 5, 5 by 9 in that case. So, 9, 9 will get cancel, and what is that we have? 2 by 5, 2 by 5 is equivalent to again 40%, 40% is less than 50% because it is the minimum confidence expected is 50%, hence it is an invalid rule again. Now, coming back to the next subset is 1, 2. So, if you write 1, 2 here, what will be remaining on the right side? That is 3. So, minimum confidence, support is 22.22%, that's okay. Coming back to the confidence, the support of 1, 2, 3 is 2 by 9, support of 1, 2 is 4 by 9, 2 by 9 divided by 4 by 9 is equivalent to 50%, which is equivalent to the minimum confidence, hence it is a valid rule. Coming to the next one, that is 1, 3, that is a subset. What is remaining on the right hand is 2 here. The confidence in this case is support of 1, 2, 3 divided by support of 1, 3, which is equivalent to 2 by 9 divided by 4 by 9, because the number of times 1, 3 is present. You just check it out. 1, 3 is present how many number of times? That is 4. Okay. So, 2 by 9, 4 by 9, that is equivalent to 50%. Which is equivalent to the minimum confidence, hence it is a valid rule. Similarly, the next subset is 2, 3, and then what is remaining is 1 here. The support is 22.22%, and confidence in this case is 66.67%, which is greater than the minimum confidence, hence this is also a valid rule. Now, considering the next item set, we have one more item set, that is 1, 2, 5. Now, we need to write the non-empty subsets. We have written here 1, 2, 5, 1, 2, 1, 5 and 2, 5. Now, considering the first subset, that is 1, the remaining is 2, 5 here. Again, the support is 22.22% because this frequent item set is appearing 2 number of times. 2 by 9 is equivalent to 22.22%. The confidence is equivalent to support of 1, 2, 5 divided by support of 1. Which is equivalent to 2 by 6, which is nothing but you can say that 33.34%, which is less than the minimum confidence, that is 50% here. Again, because of that, it is an invalid rule. Considering the next subset, that is 2, what is remaining is 1.5, support is 22.22%, and confidence in this case is 28.57%, which is less than the minimum confidence. Again, it is an invalid rule. Considering the next one, 5, the subset 5, what is remaining is 1.2, support is 22.22%, and confidence is equivalent to support of 1.25 divided by support of 5, which is equivalent to support of 1.25 is 2/9, because it is appearing 2 times, okay, and support of 2.5, you just check it out, 2.5 is appearing how many number of times, it is appearing 2 times, so 2/9, which is equivalent to 100%, so 100% is greater than 50%, that is a minimum confidence, hence it is a valid rule. Considering the next rule, that is 1.2 as a subset and remaining is 5 here, so subset support is 22.22% and confidence in this case is 50% here, which is equal to minimum confidence, hence it is a valid rule. The next one subset is 1.5 and remaining is 2 here. Now the support, so confidence of this rule is equivalent to 100%, because of that it is a valid rule. Considering the last subset, that is 2.5, remaining is 1, its confidence is again 100%, hence it is a valid rule because it is more than the minimum confidence. So this is how actually we used to calculate the rules, and then we will check whether a particular rule is valid or invalid depending on the minimum support and minimum confidence. So what we do in a priori algorithm is, first we'll try to identify the frequent item sets. Once you get the frequent item sets, we'll try to write the rules depending on the minimum support and confidence. So this is how actually we can solve the a priori algorithm. I hope this particular concept is clear. If you like the video, do like and share with your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Thank you for watching.